found you.
Here she is.
We're back.
Don't worry, Senua.
We'll look after you.
Don't worry, Senua.
Make sure you're safe.
She's safe now.
You're always safe with us.
She has us. You've done so well, Senua.
You've come so far.
Listen, Senua. Listen. You've done so well.
Listen to us.
We come to you. Listen, Senua.
We'll help you.
We're here to help you.
We'll help you go even further than you've been before.
You don't have to do this alone. Go away. I'm not listening.
I will tell you of a great hero named Sigurd, son of Sigmund, no less. Born after his father's death, Sigurd is cared for by the dwarf, Reyn. But Reyn does not love the boy. Instead, he plans to use him for his own ends. You see, Reyn's father possessed a great treasure given to him by the gods. But Reyn's brother, Fafnir, killed his father and took the gold all for himself. Fafnir hid the treasure out on a heath and could not leave it. And from the evil in his heart, he turned into a dark creature. A dragon.
She can feel it.
No.
Don't open the door.
No, go in. Don't
turn back.
What's it?
Get back! A great beast guards Helheim. Garm is its name. And it knows you are here, Senua. It can smell your stinks. What are you afraid of, Senua? How would you say Dillion if you are too much of a coward to step into the shadow?
They can't stop me.
Then do it. you from the shadows. Your sword is useless here.
To do. Your father wants them to go away, and he only hurts me to silence them. But he's gone now.
But they always come back. He says I will die if I go with them. They say that I'm already dead.
No,
and that they won't be with them.
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't
listen. Do you
to
see them?
Them?
Do you see their faces?
She escaped the darkness. She took her own life to escape it.
She can't remember when it started. When her mother lost her smile. Her eyes gazing past her towards a world she could not see. This is what happens if you reach for the underworld, he said. It was a lot to take in for a child. And the first time she felt the cold chill of fear. I didn't talk much about her father, Zinbel. I suppose I just didn't want to risk upsetting her. But it doesn't matter now, does it?
She'll have to go in.
She can't.
She has to.
She can't.
Don't
go out.
She can do it. She can't do it.
The light's gone out.
Run. Run.
Get through it as quick as you can.
She hasn't found the runes.
Rayan the Dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rayan would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Rayan reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Rayan go in search of Fafnir.
Dillian.
This is just another trial.
Just another trick. Just to distract her from her real mission.
You don't see Mother.
The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of all who owned it. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure.
the light ones. She can sense it. She's lighting the torch. It's not gonna help her. She's lighting the fire.
Do you think you can see away from the ship if you left?
Send me an
assault.
Go
it. She's done it.
Well done.
This place. It reminds her of the isolating, suffocating darkness that she threw as a young girl. Imprisoned in her room at night. The faces in the dark, coming through the walls. And she once thought everyone could see them. I mean, children all the time, isn't it? There are monsters in the dark. By the time she realized that only she could see them, her father, Zimbel, could see the monster in her.
So.
torch is going out.
No, it's not. It's gonna run out soon.
She hasn't got much time. She's too slow.
It's not going to burn out.
The darkness will come again.
I don't remember. I was only 5. They told me she escaped the darkness, that she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here? Father's keeping me away from the others. Away from Tilly. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here. I'm going to find Dewey.
We are your servants.
Save.
She knows the beast is there. She keep going towards him.
He's always
watching you.
You're never safe from him.
You can
feel him.
Be careful.
She's
behind
him.
She's behind it.
She lost it and she has to fight it.
I can feel it.
Was it?
Empty
the torch alight.
Yeah.
to save her from the darkness.
Zinbel was right.
Zinbel was trying to save her from the darkness.
And now everybody is dead.
Because of her.
All her fault.
She should have known. She should have thought.
Why doesn't she learn? Until she learns.
She doesn't understand.
Now the darkness has Dillian's soul.
And it will take it and never give it back.
She can search and search, but she will not.
She's let the darkness in. It's the end.
The darkness will take her like it took her mother.
She can't resist. Pointless even trying to retrieve it.
She's lost. Where is she going?
Although Sigurd kills the dragon, Rian wants to keep Fafnir's gold all for himself. Rian also wants the strength and wisdom of the dragon, so he drinks its blood and asks Sigurd to roast Fafnir's heart for him. Sigurd does so, but when he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby.
She's falling for it.
Sigurd's newfound power lets him hear the birds speak, and they say Sigurd should eat the heart himself. Rian wants Fafnir's gold. Sigurd should kill Rian before Rian kills him. Sigurd should find Brynhild the Valkyrie, who sleeps an enchanted sleep. Sigurd heeds the bird's advice. He kills Rian, eats Fafnir's roasted heart, and takes Fafnir's treasure. And he embarks on a new quest. To ride to Hinderfell and find Brynhild, the Valkyrie.
Thank you.
What's she doing?
She's lighting.
Holy, she's making light. She's making a fire.
She's got light on the other side.
She'll be safe. What's her plan? What's she thinking?
How's she going to get there?
So.
Darkness will swallow you.
Need to get the light.
Where is she going? Faster, keep going.
Stop.
Don't be in the middle.
Stop.
Nothing beyond its reach. How little separates us from what we fear.
There's still further to go. Go down.
She has to.
Keep the torch alight.
Sigurd learnt that Brynhild had once disobeyed Odin, and so he had her punished, stuck her with a sleep thorn, and put her body within a rampart of burning shields. Only a man who knew no fear would ever reach her. But like me, Sigurd is fearless and passes through the flames, just as I did, and wakes the sleeping warrior girl. She teaches him the secret wisdom of runes, namely victory runes, ship runes, runes for persuasion, runes for truth, runes for healing and help, runes for perception and power. Like Sigurd, the greatest young warrior of the North, you must learn the secrets of the runes to fight amongst the gods in hell.
So.
for you.
Follow my voice.
I'm coming.
People think of evil as an unnatural, invisible force, and so invoke the gods for protection. But evil can come from the hand behind the gods. A familiar hand, cold and cruel. He tried to fix her with his rituals, kept her trapped in that hole. She couldn't say which was worse. The darkness. Or the monster that her father had become. She couldn't fight them both. And so she left. Headed for the one ray of light that shone down on her. If she had stayed, she wouldn't have survived. Maybe Delian would still be alive. I'm so sorry, my love.
She will save his soul. Even if this time she can't save her own.
Senua, I know you have no reason to trust me anymore.
Shadow, listen.
But believe this, it was my mission to make you hate, to hate the darkness with a passion so great it would focus your mind on this quest. This time, I've wanted to protect you from the truth that would have destroyed you a long time ago. But you have conquered your darkness at every turn. You deserve to see behind the veil of darkness.
And take me to the mountain to trust you, as deep as we can go.
I won't stand in your way.
She has to trust him.
You will not survive what is in there.
I know. What else can she do? She doesn't want to tell us. She has nothing. She's come this far. She wants to go through. She must listen. This is it. She wants to save Dillian's soul. She must listen to the Shadow.
Feel Hela's gaze, searching for secrets inside of me. Secrets that even I can't see. I'm not here to fight my past. I'm here for Dillian. I will fulfill my vow, whatever the cost.
There has to be another way.
She can't fight.
Turn back.